Okay, guys, let's go ahead and knock off a pattern. We're gonna trace it in Clo, sew it up, all that good stuff. So to start, you should have taken photos of your garment, or you know, if it's a paper pattern, that's fine too. So you should have some photos ready to go. I don't know if this happened to you, but I took photos with my iPhone, and it has this annoying extension. And I've tried changing it to be JPEG. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but whatever. It came to my computer as this extension, H-E-I-C. So what I'm gonna do, I opened them up, and then I'm just gonna take a screenshot of them. So I think I'll start with my sleeve, I guess. I'll double click this guy. And is that a good one? I think there was like another one. Which is a good sleeve? Maybe you. Oh, that is it. Okay, let me try this one. Why don't I not like that one? I don't know which one I like better. Maybe this one. Okay. I'm going to look at this guy. Oh, geez. And it's switched. Okay. You know, the bottom gets cut off. Let's just do this one. Okay. Okay. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and take a screenshot of my sleeve. So hopefully you know how to do that on your computer. I'm on a Mac. I'm going to hit Command-Shift-4. And then I can just click and drag my cursor. Saved it on my desktop for me, so now I'm kind of ready to go. And I would do that for all, I guess, four pieces, because I have my front sleeve and my back, and I have my front bodice and my back bodice. When I did the front and back photos, just a tip, I actually only screenshot really half of it, you know, because I'm only going to draft half and just copy and paste the other half. So same with the front. Okay, so let me show you what you need to get all your photos so that you can open them in Clo, then go to Clo. I actually only have my 2D window open right now just to have a little bit more space. And I just need to make a big piece of fabric. So I think for me, I'm just gonna start with 1 yard of fabric and see how that works out for me. So I'm just gonna make a pattern piece. Right now it's default on the polygon, but I'm gonna change it to rectangle. That way I can just click one time. And then I can just type in, you know, 36 inches wide, maybe by 36 inches tall. I don't know, maybe your fabric's wider. You can make it however wide you want. I'm gonna do 36 by 36. You can always change it later. It's not that big of a deal. Okay, so next we need to get the photo inside of our fabric so that we can use our internal polygon line tool to trace it. Okay. And then once it's in internal line, then we can use our tracing tool down here to trace it and copy it as its own unique pattern piece. Okay, so we haven't done this before. I know some of you guys were kind of playing around and figured this out, but what we're gonna do, we're gonna use this tool right here. It's a graphic 2D like placement, I guess. I see the info titles getting cut off. But I'm just gonna click it one time. And then I'll just, let me try clicking it again. Okay, I clicked it one time, this window pops up. So this is where you go find your JPEG that you're gonna import. So mine was a screenshot. I know my screenshots for my computer, they automatically save on my desktop. And I've never tried doing more than one at the same time. I think you should just do one at a time. I don't know if you wanna get crazy, try doing more than one. I'm just gonna do one. And then, okay, now where do you want it? I mean, it doesn't really matter. I guess I'll just click in the middle. Okay, so this photograph is 6 inches by 9 inches. Doesn't really matter because I'm gonna resize it. Anyways, okay. So I recommend just doing one pattern piece at a time. You know, maybe if you want, you could try to get all of them in, but I think one at a time is probably easiest. Okay, so right now I know this pattern piece, it's not the right size. So I need to resize it. And I know that little red box is 2 inches by 2 inches. I also have my ruler there too to help me, or my measuring tape. So to help you resize it, a couple things. I recommend opening up your rulers. So to do that, I think this is like an easy thing to figure out if you're not sure. You're gonna go up to display, and then it's part of your environment. I don't know, once you think about it, it's kind of easy to remember, I think. And then it's down at the bottom, show ruler. So we're gonna do that. There we go. This file is in inches, so it should be good. So I think what I want to do is maybe pull out one of my rulers. Oh, you know what? I'm in my graphic tool still. So I can't pull out a guide from my ruler. I have to switch tools over here to the letter A tool. It's like my edit pattern tool. And then you should be able to hover on your ruler and click and drag with your mouse and then pull out a ruler. I'm going to drop it to where it says like 60 inches over here on the side. Then I'm going to zoom in. So I'm going to drop another one. Am I on it? Okay. Let's see. Maybe I should move it. Let's see if it'll let me move it. Yeah. Try to get exactly on that 60 inches. Then I'm going to pull another one. And I'm going to put it at 58 inches because I know they are 2 inches apart. It's also where those squares are. Maybe if you just use the squares, that's enough. I don't know. Okay, so now I want to click and drag this photo until that red square fits in between those boxes. Another thing like I could have done if I wanted to is maybe I could have taken an internal line and used the rectangle and just like, you know, click one time and then type in 2 inches by 2 inches and just make an internal box. That's another thing I could do too. So I'm just gonna do both ways. Why not? The more help, the better. Okay, so now I have to resize this photo. How am I gonna resize this photo? Because when I go to click it, it's not letting me click it. It's clicking the pattern, the fabric. So remember how we use this tool to place it? There's a tool that looks just like it with the little white arrow. That's our edit tool. So we're gonna click that one. And then this is gonna let us select this guy. I'm gonna zoom in. Okay, it has this cool like little gizmo tool here to change stuff. So to scale it, you wanna pick one of the diagonals because then it'll scale the height and the width proportionally. So it's not gonna like distort it and make it all like short and wide. So that's what you want. So I guess I'll try down here. I'm just gonna click and drag. There's not really a preview, so I'm kinda just eyeballing. So my little square is a little crooked, so I can also rotate this guy if I'd like to try to straighten out my square if that's helpful. Still kind of a little crooked. Okay, now I should be able to move just by clicking and dragging this guy. Okay, should I rotate it a hair? Okay, and I'm gonna go ahead and try to make it a little bit bigger. Cool, that looks pretty good. I can go ahead and switch tools to this edit pattern and let's see if it'll let me pick up the, it's letting me pick up my internal box. You can see it's close. it's just turned a little. But other than that, I think that this guy is 2 inches by 2 inches right now. Overall, I'm happy with the scale. I think it's gonna be close enough for me to draft the patterns and then conduct a fit and you can always change it later. Okay, I'm zooming out. Okay, so next what I recommend is re-rotating your pattern so that you know where your grain line is. So I like to work with my grain line going up and down. So I'm gonna pull out a guide over from the left ruler and use that. Okay, and then now I'm going to make sure I'm on this tool, the little graphic edit tool. I'm gonna click it, and then I can rotate this now so that my grain line is kind of going straight up and down. So I'm kind of eyeballing this right now. The twill fabric can be a little tricky because it's mostly diagonals, but I think I can do it. Let's see. Okay, I'm just kind of playing with it. Is that good? Am I off? You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna pull out another guide. Oopsies. You know what? You gotta switch tools. So Command Z. And then I'm gonna go back to that edit pattern tool, keyboard shortcut letter A. And then let's pull this out. Cause I know this guy is straight. So, okay, so now I'm gonna go back to my edit graphic tool, click this photo. I'm gonna try to turn it ever so slightly. Okay, I think right now I like this cause now when I draw this, my grain line will default this way up and down. So I think that's a good place. Okay, so I'm gonna leave this video here. You can keep watching the next video if you want to see how I trace it out using my internal polygon line tool.